And Shalom, before I get started, I want to say, Kal Halayim Lai, Yahawa Bahashem, Yahawa Shai Bahashem, Racha Kodash, which means our praises to the Heavenly Father, Yahawa, in the name of His only begotten Son, Yahawa Shai, which is our Lord and Savior, and to the Holy Spirit. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Benstone, who teach and who will, and peace and love to the elect of the nation of Israel, coming back again through the spirit power of Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai Ba'ashim, Recha Kodash, and Brother Adnan from Jimmy's Memphis camp. And pretty much the lesson is going to be being reborn again, you know, be baptized in the mind, right? Be brainwashed in the spirit, you know. So I'm going to get into it, you know, lower in this lesson. Pretty much be edifying to the elect. Lord, let the lesson be edifying to the elect, you know. So let's get it. This is Romans chapter 12 and verse 1. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of Yahweh Basha Moshiach, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice. Now, how you present your body a living sacrifice? By giving your time to the Lord, right? Give your time, right? Do the work, be instant in season, out of season, man. Onto. So like it's a living sacrifice, holy, right? Be holy, right? It's according unto the Most High, which is a reasonable self, right? This is our reasonable service, man. It's in the NOT. And so, dear brothers and sisters, I plead with you to give your bodies to Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shah, because of all He has done for you, right? Yahweh Shah died for us, man. You see? And we don't belong to ourselves. This is His body, pretty much. It's saying 1 Corinthians. I'm going to let the scriptures do the talking. 1 Corinthians 6 and 19. What know you not that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, which is in you, which you have of the Most High, and you are not your own? Why? You do not belong to yourself. You didn't create yourself. So you belong to Yahweh the Most High. For you are bought with a price. Why? We are bought with a price. You see? Yahweh's blood. So we are bought with a price. Therefore, glorify Yahweh Bashim shine your bodies. So worship Him, glorify Him, you know? And your spirit, which are the Most High, right? Which belong to Yahweh Bashim Moshiach, man. So for the Most High bought you with a high price. So you must honor the Most High with your body. Exactly. So Romans 12:1 NOT. And so, dear brothers and sisters, I plead with you to give your bodies to Yahweh Bashim Moshiach, because of all He has done for you. Let them be a living and holy sacrifice, the kind He will find acceptable, right? The kind He will find acceptable, man. You see? This is truly the way to worship Him, right? So we got to give our time to the Lord, you know? And be not conformed to this world, right? Because this world is evil, it's corrupt, right? This world belongs to the devil, Esau, Edom, right? And it's good to say that, James 4:4. Right? 1 John 2:15. 1 John 5:19, it say the whole world lies in wickedness. So be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Right? By the renewing of our mind, be transformed, be born again, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of the Most High. So the NLT, don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, right? Because this world is totally wicked. It's totally evil, corrupt. The scriptures say, Amos the 5th chapter, hate the evil and love the good. Establish judgment in the gates, right? Righteous judgment. I think I quoted that wrong. Amos 5:15, hate the evil and love the good and establish judgment in the gate. It may be that the Lord of hosts, right, the Lord Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, power of hosts, will be gracious unto the remnant of Joseph. And it's all about the remnant. You see, the elect, right? It's all about the elect. The elect gonna come back to the Lord. You see? So let's go back to Romans chapter 12 and verse 2 in the NLT. Don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, right? The behavior and customs, right? You celebrate some Easter, celebrate some Christmas, right? And the behavior and customs of this world is wicked. Now you all into Pride Month, into Mo, right? All these different philosophies out here in Babylon the Great, which is totally confusing. Right, the scriptures also say in Ephesians 4:14, be ye my children, be not tossed to and fro with every wind of doctrine, man. You know, you all into the book of Enoch, believe in some mummies. You see? Every wind of doctrine, man, the flat earth doctrine. And there's many more, right? These wicked doctrines out here. It said don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let the Most High transform you into a new person by changing the way you think, right? Yet lit. Yeah, how will Bashim, Yahweh Shai transform you into a new person by changing the way you think? So the Lord gonna give you a new mindset. He gonna what, brainwash you, man, in the spirit. You see? Then you will learn to know the Most High will for you. Then you gonna know what the Most High wants you to do and how to please the Lord. And that's what obedience, right? Obeying his laws, that's commandments, obeying his word. You see? Then you learn to know the Most High will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. You see? So, right, man. So, this is, what's that? I want to say Titus. This is Titus 3. I started 3. For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish, disobedient, deceived, serving diverse lusts and pleasures, living in malice and envy, hateful and hating one another. Right, this was us before we knew Yahweh Bashem Moshiach, before we came into the truth. We were disobedient, serving our lust, right? All into malice, we were, you know, into evil, into the flesh. This was sometimes us, foolishness, man, right? But after that, the kindness and love of the Most High, Savior towards man appeared, right? Yahweh Shai came on the scene. He died for us and said, not by works of righteousness, which we have done, but according to his mercy, he saved us, right? According to his mercy. So now we are saved by grace through faith. It's the same Ephesians, the second chapter. Lord, I get it, but according to his mercy, he saved us by the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Spirit, which he shed on us abundantly through Yahweh Shai, Mashiach, our Savior, man. So in the NLT, he saved us not because of the righteous things we had done, but because of his mercy. He washed away our sins, giving us a new birth and new life through the Holy Spirit. So with this new life, this new birth through the Holy Spirit, come what? A new mindset, right? On how to move, right? On what the Lord want us to do. You see? So this is Ephesians 4:22, my bad. No, let's get that. Ephesians 2:8. For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of the Most High. Let's read that one more time. For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah, man. So all praises to Yahweh Bashem Shah at the end of the day. So this is Ephesians 4:22, that ye put off concerning the former conversation, the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust. So throw that nigga away, right? Get rid of him, you know, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind. And how you be renewed in the spirit of your mind? By the word, you see? By the word, you know? It's a, I continue, it's saying that you put on the new man, which after the Most High is created in righteousness and truth. Right? Put on a new man, the new life. So in the NLT, throw off your sinful nature and your former way of life. Right? That old lifestyle that you was in. Right? You went to smoking blunts, right? Selling dope, being a pimp, whatever it may be, right? You walking contrary to the laws, that's commandments, man. The old lifestyle, popping pills, right? Murdering, committing adultery, getting tatted up, being a slut, a thot, right? The old lifestyle, man, which is corruptible by lust and deception, right? So instead, let the spirit renew your thoughts and attitude, right? Be brainwashed in the spirit. The spirit, you know, the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Moshiach. Put on your new nature, created to be like the Most High. Truly righteous and holy, man. You see? In the same book, I want to say, no, it's Ephesians 5.
Ephesians 5 and 2 says that he may sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, you see. Sanctify and cleanse it with the washing water of the word. I just want to get that real quick. But this is, not get ready to end it. Isaiah 55 and 6. Seek ye the Lord where he may be found. Call ye upon him while it's near, and the time is now. Right? Seek ye the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Moshiach, where he may be found, because it's going to come a time you're not going to be able to find the Lord, because the famine word is coming, right? The Lord going to withdraw his men from off the highways and byways. You're not going to have no access to him, man. That's the time of chaos, man. You know, it's saying, going back to Amos, the fifth chapter, right? Amos 5 and 4. For thus said the Lord unto the house of Israel. So the house of Israel, the 12 tribes, you so-called Negroes, Blacks, Hispanics, Latinos, and Native American Indians, and wherever the house of Israel been scattered to due to the curses who still goes back to Israelite. So this message is unto you. Seek ye me, and you shall live. Right? So come back to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, and you are going to live. Repent. You see? So being brainwashed in the spirit start with what? Repentance. Being sorrowful, right? Having regret for your actions, man. Right? To receive that new life, the true baptism, it started with what? Repentance, man. So this is going back to Isaiah 55 and verse 7. It say what? Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, man. And let him return unto the Lord. Right? Repent. Come back to the Lord and live, and he will have mercy upon him, right? The Lord going to have mercy upon you. Into our power, for he will burnly pardon, right? You see, the Lord is very merciful, man. But start by what? Depart from evil and doing good. You see, let the unwatching man forsake his thoughts, you know? So this is Jeremiah chapter 4 and 14, 144. Of Jerusalem, which is a people for its a place, right? Wash your heart from wickedness, right? Wash your heart from wickedness, man. Is this talking about the little organ in your chest between your lungs? No, it's talking about your mind. You see? Be brainwashed in the spirits. No, wash your heart from wickedness, that thou mayest be saved, right? So you can receive salvation, man, right? You think you can just get baptized and say, I'm already saved. Right, I was baptized last night. I'm saved already. No, man, all hell about to break loose. It's saying Jeremiah. This same book. Let's get it. I don't want to make the lesson long, you know. But this is Jeremiah chapter 8. Is it chapter 8? Yep, Jeremiah 8 and 20. The harvest is past. The summer is in it. And we are not saved. Right. You know, here it is. The winter came. Right? Spring came, fall came, summer came, all this shit happened, the seasons happened, and guess what? You still not saved, Jake. Because saved, pretty much going to victory over death. And you can't stop yourself from dying, man. You know? You can't stop yourself from dying. So you're not saved. So going back to Jeremiah, let's read that again. Jeremiah 4 and 14. It say, O Jerusalem, wash thy heart from wickedness, right? Depart from evil and do good, right? Start walking contrary to the Lord, you know, and keep his ways, right? It say, they'll deliver for the noise of the archers. They should have rehearsed the righteous acts of the Lord, man. You see? So you got to keep the laws, that's commandments, to the best of your ability, man. It says, O Jerusalem, watch thy heart from wickedness, that thou mayest be saved. How long shall thy vain thoughts lodge within thee? So, and it's all stopped with what? Taking heed according to the word. Like it's Psalms 119 and verse 9. Wherewith all shall young man clear his way? By taking heed thereto according to that word. Going right back to the what? Ephesians chapter 5 and 26. That he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, even the Lord himself, John 15:3. Now you are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Right? This is James 1:21. Wherefore, lay apart all filthiness and superfluity of naughtiness, and receive with meekness the engrafted word, which is able to save your soul. So being brainwashed in the spirit, start with what? Receiving this word. And start with what? Repentance. Coming back to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai. You know, you take off that old man, you have what? A new man, which is after righteousness, which is after holiness, repentance. You see? So be brainwashed in the spirit, you know. Repent. Come back to the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. With that, Shalom. Come out, Shalom. Wa ba ba.